please head over to my webpage at www.cribzone.co.za and come and check out the page. You will notice there is a lot of information on there. Hyperlinks are provided so that you don't have a problem going anywhere. Head up to my podcast page and come and see what am I currently working on my podcast. There is also the CribZone Live page, which I will update regularly to let you know when I'm going to do the next show like this one. The goal is to try and do one every week. Head on over to my CribZone YouTube page and come and check out what are the latest videos that I am working on and also what new videos is up and coming. If you have any queries or questions, don't hesitate to ask. You can email me at shawl.reaper@gmail.com. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And we've got a project again. Can you believe it? I know it's a bit of a stupid project and it's not something ooladida wonderful. But today I'm going to install an electric panel heater in the kids' room. So let's see what I got. I bought this solo heater, and as you can plainly see, everything's in Spanish. There's nothing in English, but I'm sure the installation is actually quite straightforward. So I'm going to quickly unbox it. And here you see the heater. It's plain in the front, and here at the back, you've got your on and off switch. There used to be another panel heater on this wall, and the new ones that we got does not fit. The Fisher plugs is too small, so we are going to have to fill up the holes. So I'm using polyfiller, and I am busy plugging up the holes, as you can see. This is just to show you that I have covered up all the holes with the polyfiller. Use some sandpaper and sand off all the polyfiller once it's dry. It's just to smooth the wall again, so that if later on you want to paint it, then you can paint it without having anything sticking out or any uneven surfaces. At the moment I don't have any paint, so I'm just going to put the heater over the polyfiller so you won't even see it. Panel heater against the wall where you want to mount it, and use a level. And with the level in place, you can use a Cokie or marker and mark the holes where you want to drill them. Take your Fisher plug, put it right next to your drill bit, and where it stops, take some masking tape and then just put it around your drill bit. This is to give an indicator of how deep you can put your drill bit in, so it doesn't, so you don't drill too deep into the hole. And there you go, as you can see, we've got our plugs in, and now we're going to tighten the spacer in place. And voila, the spacers are on. Now it's time to put on your heater. To put your panel heater on, and then put these caps over to hold the whole thing in place. And then of course, clean and wipe off everything that you made dirty, clean the floors, and go and pack away your tools. Done, nice and clean, heater is nice and level, it's plugged in and it works. Well, thanks guys, thanks for watching this channel, and stay tuned for the last piece of messages. Until next time, cheers.
Hi guys, subscribe to my channel now so that you do not forget. Hit that bell icon and get notified of my further uploads. nicely, feel free to comment. Show me some love by giving me a thumbs up at the end of the video.